Hello. This is going to be my first video on some of the information in Chapter 6. I'll make this one over the Bartlett War of the Ghosts study. So, Bartlett believed that we have schemas or schemata stored in human memory that help us make sense out of our experiences and help us organize our experiences and help us change our memories, right? We enter information and these schemata will actually change those memories. Of course, we are unaware of this on a conscious level. So we had participants read and study this Native American story from the northwestern United States called The War of the Ghosts. It's a story about two warriors who go out, and when they're spending an evening out in nature, they witness this war of the ghosts, ghosts having a war with each other, a battle. And they study this story, The War of the Ghosts, until they have it in their long-term memory. They're able to reproduce it accurately without any mistakes. And then he would ask the participants to come back after various periods of time and recall the story again, recall the memory for the story again. So it involved serial recall, S-E-R-I-A-L, have them come in repeatedly, serially over time, and recall the story. And he kept track of what they said each time. Didn't correct them when they came back, right? Just took down what they said, what they recalled the story to be. And he found that over time, the story, their recall for the story, became more and more inaccurate. So their memory was becoming more inaccurate over time. The participants, however, were unaware of this. In fact, their memory for the story was changing, but it was changing in a way that made more rational sense to the individual. And Bartlett argued, of course, that the memory was being shaped and changed by the individual's schemata, right? So the memory was becoming more inaccurate. At the same time, it was becoming, from that person's point of view, more rational. It made better sense. It was more structured than the original Native American story was. So the participants were unaware that their memory was becoming more inaccurate, perhaps due in large part to the fact that it was being shaped to be consistent with their schemata. So this led Bartlett to believe that memory is reconstructive in nature, right? Long-term memories are reconstructive in nature. We don't take in all the facts, store all the facts, and willy-nilly, at some later point, perfectly recall all the details. We do not do that. Memory is reconstructed. It's reconstructive in nature, right? And we see that this has really big implications for more recent research by Elizabeth Loftus on eyewitness memory. We watched the video of her, right? And the huge debate nowadays, which can be controversial, between recovered, repressed memories and false memories. So we believe nowadays that memory is reconstructive in nature, and we can't really take it as being accurate, eyewitness memory. What we need is for there to be independent, corroborative evidence for us to believe an eyewitness's memory. So there needs to be independent information that corroborates the memory. And we have to base our judgment of how accurate the memory is on this corroborating evidence. Without that corroborating evidence, we have no way of judging how accurate an individual's memory is. So our subjective sense is that we are remembering it in detail. But what the research shows is we're reconstructing it. So are we really who we think we are? Ooh.